This is the first of a series of videos which will describe how to set up a total station using the setup app. That is, how to position and orientate the total station. In this video, I will start with an explanation of the different methods and which use case is suitable for which method. Further videos will go into detail and show step by step how to use them. The setup app includes all methods which are needed to set up a total station. Let's start the app and take a look. As with any app, move the job you want to use to the centre of the carousel and choose the setup app. Here it is possible to choose which method to use. There are six methods to choose from: set orientation, known backsight, multiple backsight, transfer height, resection, and orientation to line. Let's run through the set orientation method. Use set orientation in the following case: if the point over which you will position the total station is known, you know the orientation to the backsight point. That is, you know the direction from where the total station will be positioned to the backsight. This could be a church tower, a cross on a mountaintop, or any other known point. And you don't need to be able to measure a distance to the backsight. That is optional, but you do need to be able to see the backsight. Use the known backsight method in the following case: if the point over which you will position the total station is known, there is only one backsight and the point over where the backsight is located is known. Normally this will be a prism mounted on a tripod, but it could also be a reflective tape mounted on a wall, or even simply a mark on a wall. You don't need to be able to measure a distance to the backsight, that's optional, but you do need to be able to see the backsight. Use the multiple backsights method in the following case: if the point over which you will position the total station is known, the point over which the backsight or backsights is known. Note that in this method, it is possible to measure to one or more backsights. If you measure to more than one backsight, then a best fit of all the backsight measurements will be made, which may improve the orientation. Optionally, the height of the setup can be transferred from the backsight measurements. This may be useful if you do not know or do not trust the height of the setup location. Use the transfer height method in the following case: if the point over which you will position the total station is known, but not the height, and you simply need to establish the height of the total station by measuring to one or more points of which the heights are known. Note that the orientation of the total station would already be correct, or you don't care what is the orientation. The resection method is the first of two methods which allows the total station to be located anywhere. That is, the total station is not located over any point of known coordinates. In order to position and orientate the total station, it is needed to measure to at least two backsight points. The position and height of the location of the total station will then be computed based on the measurements to the backsights. Before completing the setup, it is possible to look at the quality of the measurements to the backsights and exclude any measurements which may be considered erroneous. The orientate to line method is the second of two methods which allows the total station to be located anywhere, and also the backsight points are not known. But how can this be possible, and why would anyone want to use this method? Well, imagine if you need to measure a road traffic accident. In this case, it is simply needed to measure the cars and street furniture relative to each other. It could be really useful to orientate everything relative to the edge of the road, for example. So in this method, the total station can be located anywhere which is suitable. It is then simply needed to measure to two points. These two points then define the northing or easting axis, with the first measurement being given the coordinates 0, 0. All subsequently measured points are then related to this axis, that is, related to the edge of the road in our example. So it is clear that there are plenty of methods to choose from. The method to use primarily depends on where you are positioning the total station and how many backsights are being used. Please watch the other videos to learn more about the individual methods, and thanks for watching.